So first of all, I've seen you do a special dance in the Nickelodeon show.
Yeah, Yo Gabba Gabba. Gabba Gabba, yeah, sure.
I was wondering if you'd be on for recreating that.
Oh, yes. I remember there's sort of this bit. And then, yeah, it's the puppet master. It's like this, and like this, and like this, and then like this. Do the puppet master like that. That's essentially it. Thanks, Luke.
Quickly, what was it, love?
Yes.
Will you please sign my book?
Yeah, of course. Yay. What's the book?
Lord of the Rings.
Hold on. You obviously, who we normally get in Yellow Pages. Okay.
Yes.
You don't know with this bloody audience.
Hold his off.
That's pretty bloody book. Oh, of course, it's a trilogy. Really fun.
Unbelievable. Yes. This makes for a cracking telly, this.
Oh, this is... What are you doing, Lila? Anything there?
Thank you. Eliza, we've got a question now from one of your co-stars, none other than Sir Ian of McKellen.
Oh, wow.
Now, my question, I'm often asked, was Frodo gay? And I say, well, never in front of the cameras. What's your view?
Was Frodo gay? No. No, it's interesting. It's a real argument. It's a discussion that has been occurring over many, many years. I think it's up for interpretation. The character itself, I think, you know, people can put anything onto the character.
Well, that looks a bit dodgy.
How do you explain that?
Get a room.
Well... Yeah. I'm looking at that thinking, I'm no expert, but Samwise has definitely just blown his spuds.
I think, is that post-coital?
I think it's post.
Yeah. You reckon?
Yeah, I mean, Samwise wants a little cigarette just laying around his mouth. He's got a little puff.
After this, he went and made some tea and toast.
Yeah. It's on Mount Doom as well.
Is that what you call it?
We've got another question now, Elijah, from another one of your co-stars.
Oh.
From your new movie, The Oxford Murders, it's none other than John of Hurt.
Elijah, it's come to my notice that when you finished Lord of the Rings, you and your fellow cast members had a tattoo, which was common to you all, somewhere on your body. My question is, what tattoo would you suggest that we had to mark our time together in Oxford Murders?
Oh, I love that man too. That was so perfect.
I know, it's the power.
Mm. I felt he was mentally undressing me as he was.
What tattoo would you have?
John, only just met.
It's a good question. What
it
tattoo
is a
would
great
you have?
Question. Probably this, a series of four symbols called the Idiot Series. These symbols that on their own look like they're not connected, but literally they are. So it applies to the film, might be kind of a nice tattoo.
So you have a tattoo somewhere on your person from The Lord of the Rings, is that right? Whereabouts is it?
It's on my pelvis.
Get it out.
I'll tell you what, first of all, let's have a look at Sir Ian McKellen showing us where his is. Have
oh,
a look
my
at
God.
This.
Oh, God.
Mine's there.
Oh. Wow.
On the shoulder.
He showed it. I think it's time... See, because initially when we got the tattoo, we thought we can't show it, because if we do, then many people will be able to copy it. It'll take it away from being very special, but...
Elijah, let's see it.
It's Elvish for the number 9.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the significance of 9 being?
9 members of the Fellowship.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's have another question. The lady just on the right-hand side with the glasses on and a black shirt.
Hi.
Hi.
What's your name, love?
Frida.
Hi. Hi, Frida.
Hi there. Which member of the Fellowship was the best kisser?
I think she's implying that I would know that.
Well, you kiss a lot of rings.
I think I'm pretty good. I wouldn't know about the other gentleman.
In that case, can I get a demonstration?
Oh, Frida. Oh, Frida, if you approach the stage, you will be tasered. Signing books, asking for kids, that Jim will fix it.
Thank you all so much for your questions. Great, thank you.
After the break, I'll be trying to win one lucky audience member some fantastic prizes. First, though, I have to choose that person.
Elijah, we want you to pick the person that looks most like Gollum. So if Elijah picks you, it means he thinks you look like someone who lives in a cave, eats raw fish, and is desperate for the ring. Bad times, but you do get the chance to win loads of fantastic prizes. Good times. Elijah, off you go, sir. Find out who Elijah chooses after the break.
Harry! Come on, Ghibli.
Slow down, Legolas. I'm bloody knackered. Tell us in part four. I'll have my breath back by then. Welcome back to the climax of the Friday Night Project. Before the break, we asked Elijah to choose the audience member who he thought looked like Gollum. Elijah, who have you chosen?
You. Stop it here. All right, what's your name?
Ashley.
Ashley.
Come on down, Ashley. It's time to play the Elijah Woods Big Fun Game Show. Welcome to the Elijah Wood Big Fun Game Show, where Elijah gets to play big fun games to win big fun prizes for Ashley. Where's Ashley? He's on the prize wheel. Hi, Ash. Hey, Ashley. Can you hear me, love?
Yeah.
Great. Do you feel sick, Ash?
Yeah.
I haven't even spun him yet.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, this is how it's going to work. Elijah will spin you around, Ashley. Whichever prize you land on, that's what we'll play for. If Elijah wins the game, you, Ashley, shall win the prize. But before we play, here to tell us what's on the prize wheel tonight is the cast of the Lord of the Rings musical. Take it away, Frodo and the gang.
Well, Justin, on the prize wheel tonight is...
a 37-inch LCD TV.
A games console.
And a digital camera.
Cracking prizes.
Yes, brilliant prizes.
Also on the wheel are a DVD player, an MP3 player, and, of course, the FNP, his and hers pants.
Great
pants. Great pants.
Nice.
Elijah, please spin the wheel to find out what we're playing for in game one. Ashley, hold on. Big MP3.
MP3.
Okay. The first game is karaoke. Elijah, which American diva has recently had twins and asked Tom Cruise to be their godfather? Before you answer,